Bonjour à tous. Hi everyone and welcome to Learn French with Vincent. This is Unité 7, Leçon A. And in this lesson, we'll work together on the adverbs, les adverbes. And to be more precise, we'll see three cases. The first one will be with an adjectif, an adverb. Second situation will be with un verbe. And then the last one will be with une phrase. Okay, so let's see that right now. The first case we'll discover or we'll work on will be with an adjective or an adverb. Okay, so let's see. The idea is normally that the adverb should be placed, adverb placé, devant, before the adjective or the other adverb. Okay, so if you've got a structure with one adverb and one adjective, your adverb should be placed before the adjective. If you've got two adverbs, then this one should be before the second one. Okay, so let's see how it goes. First example, ce thé est trop chaud. Okay, ce thé, thé is tea, of course. And then here we've got the demonstrative. This tea is too hot. Okay, so we've got the adjective chaud here, and then this trop should be before the adjective. Okay, so it's quite easy. Another possibility here, you've got two adverbs. So this one, trop, too, and then rapidement, well, fast, okay? And then parler is to talk. Il parle trop rapidement. Okay, so obviously this trop, too fast, should be before rapidement. Okay? And then, last example, ce film est assez intéressant. Ce film est assez, enough, intéressant, interesting. Okay, so assez comes before intéressant. Alright, so remember, if you've got one adverb, then you should put it before the adjective or the second adverb. Alright, so let's see now how you will construct it if you have a verb. So the rule goes like that. L'adverbe est placé, is placed, so the adverb is placed en général, in general, so that's quite important in French because, of course, we've got exceptions all the time. We will have exceptions in French, but en général, okay? Après, so after the verb, okay? Adverbe placé en général après le verbe. So let's see how it goes now. Je lis, lire. Lire is to read, okay? So it's the present form. Je lis, I read, rapidement, okay? So fast. Je lis rapidement. So you can see that this rapidement, fast, comes after your verb here, lire. Okay? Second example now. Elle parle, parle is to talk, doucement. Okay, quietly. Elle parle doucement. Same thing here. Your adverb is coming after your verb. All right? And then the last one. Il conduit, conduire is to drive. Il conduit. Très bien, very well, sa nouvelle voiture, his new car. Il conduit très bien sa nouvelle voiture. So as you can see here as well, this très bien, very well, is coming after the verb conduire, to drive. All right, so remember, the adverb is placed in general after the verb. Okay, and then be careful, of course, if you construct it at the passé composé tense. So remember, we saw that previously. You should check the unit 5 if you want to know how to construct this passé composé. But then for the passé composé, we will have, of course, some exceptions. The exceptions are assez, enough, beaucoup, a lot, bien, well, déjà, already, mal, bad, mieux, better, trop, too much, too, okay, toujours, always, and then presque, almost, okay, so assez, beaucoup, bien, déjà, mal, mieux, trop, toujours, presque. So, try to remember them, and then in the next page, I will show you how they change. So if you take this trop, remember it was too much. So, je parle trop. I talk too much. So if we've got the present form as we do here, basically it does respect the rule as we saw previously. So it comes after the verb. Okay, je parle trop. But then, if you put the same sentence at the passé composé form, okay? So remember, passé composé, you've got avoir or être, and then after that you get this participe passé form, all right? So you will have to put this adverb, trop, between the two here. J'ai trop parlé. All right? Let's see now another example. Il se repose. Se reposer is to rest. Okay? Il se repose beaucoup, a lot. And then, if you put the same sentence at the passé composé form, il s'est beaucoup reposé. All right? Il s'est beaucoup reposé. So remember, present here, present form, you've got this adverb, it's coming after the verb, but then here, it must be here, so between the two. Okay? Another example. Je dors mal. So dormir, it's to sleep. Okay? Mal, bad. Passé composé form. J'ai mal dormi. So same thing. Doesn't come after, but it's right here. Okay? Elle sourit toujours. Sourire, to smile. Toujours, always. Present form, elle sourit toujours. And then, passé composé form, elle a toujours souri. All right? And now, let's see if you want to make a sentence. Because you will have to remember that in some cases, well, the place of the adverb can change. Est variable. Okay? So let's see. You've got an example here. Malheureusement, so malheureusement means unfortunately, malheureusement, elle a perdu ses clés. Perdre, it's to lose, okay? Ses clés, her keys, okay? And it's the passé composé form. Malheureusement, elle a perdu ses clés. Okay, so that's one option. So you can start here, as you can see. You start with the adverb, and then you continue your sentence. All right, but then it would be possible as well to change the order and to start like elle a perdu ses clés, malheureusement. Okay, so you can see that it's possible to start with the adverb or then you can end with it as well. So it's possible to move the adverb in this case. It doesn't need to be at the right beginning of the sentence. Okay, we'll see another example. Récemment means recently. Il a décidé, okay, décidé to decide, de changer, to change, de travail. Travail is work. Okay? Récemment, il a décidé de changer de travail. Okay? And it will be the same here. If you look carefully, you can start with il a décidé de changer de travail. So the same portion that we had here. You can start with it. And then you put récemment at the end. Okay, so in some structures, well, keep in mind that it's possible whether to start with the adverb or that to end with the adverb if you want. Okay, well, it's for once, it's quite easy in French. All right, okay, so I hope it was clear. So this was the first lesson of Unit 7, Unité 7. If you want more lessons, well, you can find them here. And then the website is waiting for you, imagier.net. Have a great day. Bye-bye.